In a previous video, we learned about some of the components that make up HTTP requests and responses. That include things like the status codes or the HTTP headers, or even the body that gets sent over in the message. Now, when it comes to building web APIs, there's usually a common set of conventions that our industry uses to map those components to the types of work we want our API to do. In this video, we're going to take a look at some of those conventions and learn how to implement them inside of ASP.NET Core. Now, when we talk about APIs, we usually look at them as a common set of operations that we want to execute against a given collection of resources. So for instance, those resources might be, you know, products in our inventory or contacts in our address book, recipes inside of your recipe book. And once you have those resources, there's usually a common set of operations that you want to execute. For instance, I might want to create a new one or delete one. I might want to update an existing one or issue a query to retrieve some of the ones that we already have. And it turns out HTTP has already defined ways that we could execute these types of requests from our client. If you take a look at the table, on the left side, you can see I've defined some common actions. So create, read, update, and delete. And in the next column, I've also listed some HTTP methods that match those given actions. So for instance, if I wanted to create something, I can issue a post request. If I wanted to read something, I could issue a get request. In the last two columns, these have to do with the responses that get returned from the server. So now we need to know what is the status of that particular request. Was it successful or not? Were things created or were they not? Were they found or were they not found? Was everything okay? And we use HTTP status codes to issue those things. And that's what you're seeing here right now. Now, these aren't all the HTTP methods and all the HTTP status codes that you could use when you're building your API, but I think it's a really good start. So why don't we head over to Visual Studio and see how we can implement some of these conventions. The first thing that we'll do is open that recipes controller we created in the previous video. You'll notice that I've added some additional action methods to our controller. So we have get recipes, create new recipes, and also delete recipes. Notice all these actions have their associated HTTP method with them. So when I want to get things, I'm using HTTP get. When I want to create things, I'm using HTTP post. And also when I want to delete things, I'm using HTTP delete. And these should match some of those conventions that we saw in that previous diagram. If I decide to open up the get recipes, again, you'll notice that I'm still following some of those common conventions. So when I want to return information, and let's say this operation was successful, I could use OK. And that'll return that OK status code, and I could just give it the payload that I wanted to return. And you can see that on line 21. If for whatever reason I was unable to find my recipes, well, I can just return a not found status code. And I could use that with the not found method that you see me using on line 20. Now, let's take a look at the HTTP delete operation, and this shouldn't be too much different. Now, if everything was successful and I was able to delete this resource, then I'll just return no content. And that just means that, well, it was successful and there wasn't anything that I needed to return. Also, if something bad happened and maybe I was unable to delete it for whatever reason, then I'll return like a bad request. And you can see I'm doing that there on line 42. Now, you might notice that, you know, I don't have all the necessary operations implemented. So as an exercise for you, why don't you try creating an update operation to update the particular recipe resource? Now, remember, you have to use the right HTTP method and status codes. So try it out and let us know how it works out. In the next video, we're going to take a look at routing and learn how we can customize that inside of ASP.NET Core.